Good morning, students. I am Professor Nitin Kadolia from Sagar Group of Institutions, Bhopal. So today I'll be taking a topic of consumer behavior, which is the subject of MBA semester 3. So, consumer behavior. Let us first understand what do we understand by consumer behavior. So, consumer behavior is the study of when, why, how, and where people do or do not buy a product. It basically depends on the psychology of the consumer. It attempts to understand the buyer decision-making process, both individually and in groups. It studies the individual consumers, such as demographics and behavioral aspects, to understand the people's wants. In the study of consumer behavior, main focus is the customer satisfaction, because customer is the only person with whose presence businesses actually exist. So, what do we understand? We understand that there are so many companies in the market, so many organizations are there, and they all have different products or services with them to offer for the end user or the consumer. And to market these products or services to the consumer, they need to understand the behavior of the customer. I mean, when does a customer plan to buy? Why does he buy? What is his buying pattern? What psychology the consumer have behind buying or availing any product or services? Where do this customer go and buy a product? What does he buy and what does he not prefer to buy? So all these things are studied under this branch of study in MBA. This is consumer behavior. So let us first understand the basic types of consumers. The consumers are basically, they can be broadly taken into four categories. Consumer, the buyers can be taken into four categories: the consumer, the customer, the institutional buyers, and the ultimate customers. So let us understand what these four types mean. Consumer, according to International Dictionary of Management, consumer is a purchaser of goods and services for immediate use or consumption. For example, we take a product, we take a bottle of mineral water, we take a toothpaste, we take a bathing soap. So what we do, purchase it, we go home, we use it, and the product perishes. Okay. So this is consumer who purchases the products and use and consumes the product. Now, who's the buyer? Buyer is the person who purchases goods either for resale or for use in production or for use of somebody else. Then the customer, he is the one who purchases goods for his own use or for the use of others, or else he is a regular customer of a particular product and he is a regular customer of a particular shop. Who are institutional buyers? These are either government institutions or private organizations. Normally, these institutional buyers, they buy product in bulk. Say a TVS two-wheeler, a motorcycle of TVS, there may be many parts who this TVS company would be buying from some other organization. Battery, for example, right? Battery, there may be an Amron battery, there may be an Exide battery, a Luminous battery inside your TVS motorcycle. So these fall into the category of institutional buyers. Now we come to the characteristics of consumer behavior. So consumer behavior is a process where consumer decide what to buy, when to buy, how to buy, where to buy, and how much to buy. It comprises of both mental and physical activities of consumer. Consumer behavior is very complex and dynamic, which keeps on changing constantly. Individual buying behavior is affected by various internal factors, What are the internal factors? The needs, wants, attitudes, and motives. There are certain external factors also that affect the buying behavior. They are the social groups, the culture, the status, the environmental factors, etc. Consumer's behavior starts before buying and it goes on even after the sale is closed or the buying has happened. Then comes the importance or need of the study of consumer behavior. Why do we need to study this consumer behavior? See, I have already told there are so many companies with so many products and services. Now they have to sell this product. The money has to come from the customer. Now, the company wants to sell, the customer has a need to buy. But the companies or the organizations need to understand the behavior, the psychology of the customer. Then only they are able to better pitch in, or they can manage their sales strategy or sales pitch in such a fashion that they can motivate the customer to buy their product. So, what are the importance or the need of the study of consumer behavior? To make better strategies for increasing profits, to take into consideration customers' health, hygiene, and fitness, to know the buying decisions and how consumers make consumption, consistent change in consumers' tastes or preferences. Consumer behavior study is necessary to make pricing policies to avoid future market failures. So these are the points because of which there is a need to study the consumer behavior. Now the types of consumer behavior. Consumer behavior can broadly be categorized into four categories: complex, dissonance reducing, variety seeking, and habitual. This complex buying behavior has high involvement of the customer into the product or services, and there are significant differences between brands. When we talk about variety seeking buying behavior, the customer has a low involvement. On the contrary, when dissonance reducing buying behavior, there are few differences between brands. When a customer has selected some alternatives, depending upon his need, first the customer will identify the problem, then he will search for the alternatives. And then when there are few differences between brands and the customer has high involvement in the buying, then we call it a dissonance reducing buying behavior. And finally, habitual buying behavior, when the customer has low involvement and there are few differences between brands. This normally happens when the price of the product is not very high and the product is not for the use for the longer period of time. Then normally this kind of behavior is seen from the customer. Okay, so today in this class we are going to do up till here. In our next class we will continue from this. Thank you so much.